Good morning, Chairman Barash and Executive Director O'Toole. I believe strongly that as a state and perhaps the largest employer in the Commonwealth, that we should be a model employer. And to that extent, we should do what we can to ensure that we remove any barriers to employment, as well as retain and advance qualified both minority women and even disabled employees in careers in government. I see that you have a staff of about 308, is that correct?
Yes.
Do you have a breakdown of your demographics of staff in regards to the numbers of women and minority employees?
Yes, I do. 60% of the staff is male, 40% is female, and just under 17% is minority inside of our organization.
I have numbers about the casinos,
which you would probably find interesting.
Will you share that as well?
Yeah. Overall, statewide, all of our casinos, 56% male, 44% female, and just under 34% minority. That's total employment, but I also think it's worth noting that among executive and management positions, 62% male, 38% female, and 21% minority.
And as far as executive and management positions within your agency, do you have a breakdown of that?
I don't have that. I only have it by the total agency.
By the total?
I'm sorry.
Okay. Separately, there's been a lot of conversations recently about second chance legislation, which our governor recently signed into law. And there's recent conversation of a ban to box legislation. I understand that in your industry there are certain backgrounds that would prevent individuals from employment. But are there opportunities within your agency and within casinos for individuals with criminal backgrounds, and do you make any efforts to hire those individuals?
Well, I'll speak for myself personally, and then I'm going to turn the detail over to Mr. O'Toole. I'd be a proponent, certainly, of second chance and ban the box. I come from a law enforcement prosecutorial background, and everybody knows that someplace between the ages of 17 and 24, people have no brains. And I don't think...
Some people.
Well, I was once that age, and I had very little in the way of brains. But I'm just saying that I'm not making light of serious crime, but an awful lot of things that end up making it impossible for somebody to get a decent job for the rest of their life are some stupid things they did at the age of 17 or 18, and I don't think that helps anything to take a whole chunk of the population and resign them to a third or fourth class existence. So that's my personal views. As far as what the casinos are doing and particular rules, our background checks certainly do include consideration of a person's criminal background, but in more detail, I'll turn to Kevin on that.
Thank you, Representative. From the casinos' perspective, what we've seen in the last 4 or 5 years is casinos are focusing a lot of their efforts on non-gaming amenities. They're creating more food and beverage outlets. They're creating convention space and ballrooms, which will continue to employ people off of the gaming floor in completely non-gaming positions. In those positions, we do not license many of those off the gaming floor non-casino jobs. So we certainly would encourage the casinos to look at all applicants, so long as they're qualified, regardless of any other history. They're not required to do a background for those off the gaming floor personnel. But if they need a gaming license, there is an automatic disqualifier if you have a felony conviction that's within a 15-year period. That's a pretty standard criteria throughout the nation for casino employees.
Thank you.